Honda's Maze is back from the parlor with a little more show, of course. We drove the baby sedan over the weekend. Here are 11 things you should know if you're eyeing it. Honda hasn't really fiddled with the design all that much. That's a good thing. We think its appeal lies in its simplicity. There's no change to the sheet metal, just a minor nip and tuck for the grille and the bumpers. Both bumpers now get a splattering of chrome. There's chrome on the door handles and the grille gets, you guessed it, more chrome. The bigger visual standout, however, is the LED lighting. You now have automatic LED projector headlamps, white LED fog lamps and LED guidelines in the tail lamps as well. It does look rather cool. Yes, this little Honda still runs on VD 175 section tires. The upside is that the 15-inch alloy wheels have been borrowed from the 4th generation City's parts bin. They're diamond cut too, if you care for that stuff. The interior remains virtually unchanged, save for the matte silver bits you see on the dashboard, the door pads, and some different upholstery. Sadly though, there's still no leather wrap for the steering wheel or the seats, and the rear headrests continue to be fixed, not adjustable. And if you were expecting loads of new features inside the cabin of the new Amaze, there are exactly zero new features here. You still get keyless entry, push-button start, cruise control, climate control, and a 7-inch touchscreen with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Small update, you now get to switch between camera views. Annoyingly enough, all the features we just talked about are limited to the top spec VX variant, and there's no sign of wireless charging, rear AC vents, or that much speculated sunroof. Thankfully though, safety tech is standard across the range, and that includes dual airbags, ABS with EBD, and ISOFIX child seat mounts. Whether it's your kid in the child seat in the rear or you, no one's going to be whining about space. For its size, the new Amaze was adequately spacious, and it's no different with this mild update either. There's an armrest that lets you relax a little more, but a USB port or two instead of the 12-volt socket here would have been a great addition. Engine and gearbox options remain unchanged, but there's less of a choice now. The V variant is now gone, which means the petrol CVT is available in two variants and the diesel CVT in just one. We've driven all four versions and no, they don't feel any different to drive. This means the petrol remains the go-to pick if you want a no-nonsense city commuter. Pick the CVT if you want some added convenience. Don't expect fun from this engine though. For highway runs or heavy city commuting, you'd want more power and more efficiency, which is where the diesel engine will shine. The diesel CVT is a great option to have, although we do wish Honda gave it the full 100 horsepower tune. The Amaze's soft ride ensures city commutes are properly comfortable. It cushions the rough stuff enough for you to not be bothered. For highway runs at triple digit speeds, it doesn't give you a reason to complain either. Just treat it like the comfy family sedan it is, and you're good. So, is there a new reason to consider the Amaze? Well, just one. It now looks better. Other than that, this little Honda continues to be a comfortable and spacious small sedan. What makes this deal sweeter is that the price hike for this update is negligible. That's all you need to know to make a decision. Did we miss out on anything? Leave those questions in the comments below. We'll see you in the next one. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Zigwheels.